Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how you can use almost any sound file as a ringtone on your iPhone. MacMost is brought to you by more than 500 supporters just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Okay, so you're not just stuck with the ringtones that come with your iPhone. You probably know that you can buy some, but you can also get just about anything for free. All you need is the actual sound file. So this could be something you made up or something you downloaded or got from a collection. Any basic sound file you have can be turned into a ringtone. The first thing you need, though, is the GarageBand app. So go to the Mac App Store, search for GarageBand, it's from Apple, and download it if you don't already have that on your iPhone. This is what you need to create ringtones. Now before we go into the app, let's look in the Files app because this is where you want to get your sound file. Whether this is a song from an artist that you downloaded or it's something you created or found in a collection, you want to get it in the Files app. And the Files app contains all the files that are in your iCloud drive and also files that could be stored locally. So if I look here in the Files app, I'll see all the different locations I've got. I've got iCloud Drive, I've got on my iPhone. You may have other things like Dropbox or different cloud services. If I look in iCloud Drive, I'll see all the same folders that I should see on my Mac under iCloud Drive. Now, I happen to have under Documents a folder called Sample Audio. And in here, I've got a few different files, some WAV files and an MP3 file. Notice the cloud icon next to a few of these. This means the file hasn't been downloaded yet. It's in the cloud but not on your iPhone. You can just basically tap on the cloud there and it will download. You want to make sure you have whatever file that you're going to use in a ringtone downloaded so it's ready to go. Now likewise, you could be in Safari browsing a website with some free sound files and go to download some. So for instance, here's some at archive.org. There's a lot of royalty-free music there. I know SoundCloud also is another place a lot of people go to get some. And if you want to download something, you can download it just like you do on a desktop computer. For instance, I can tap and hold a link and it comes up with a list of options. And one of those is download linked file. So I'll select that. Then I'll go back into the Files app. Now if I go up to the top level here and if I look under iCloud Drive, you should see a downloads folder. And there, sure enough, just like a downloads folder on the Mac, there's the file that I downloaded. So if I want to get this file, I can go to the Downloads folder. Those other ones, they were in iCloud Drive in that Sample Audio folder. So now that you know where the file is that you want to use, you can go into GarageBand and use it to create a ringtone. So I'm going to launch GarageBand and then I'm going to start off by creating a new project. There's a plus button at the top right corner. I'm going to create that and you can use a lot of different things to start off a new project. Doesn't really matter because we're not going to use anything in the original project. I'm just going to select Audio Recorder. It'll create a new project and I'm immediately going to tap the button here at the top that allows me to see all the different tracks. Now I'm going to import that sound as another track. The way to do that is to tap the Loops button at the top right. And you have different options here. You have your Apple Loops, Files, and Music. As you can guess, I'm going to go to Files here. And then I'm going to look for that file. So I'm going to tap the Browse Items from the Files app and then it goes in here and you can actually see Recents and see those recent ones. Or I can go to Browse and I could dig down to find those files. So for instance, I could go to that Downloads folder and there's that one file. Or I could dig down into my Documents folder and find that Sample Audio folder. So here I am in there. So to use one of these, I simply tap it and now it will appear here in this list. So you can see I've actually got two of them because I selected it before. I need to tap and then drag over to the left to add it to the project as a separate track. And now you can see the audio waveform in there. It's ready to go. Now the one thing you may want to keep in mind is ringtones have to be short, typically under 30 seconds. So the song's probably a lot longer than that, right? So you may want to go and cut it off. For instance, I could move the playback head to some point here. Now you want to cut it right there. So I'm going to select it with a tap and then a quick tap to bring up the menu and then hit split. And then you get this little arrow with the scissors and all I need to do is quick swipe down to do a quick cut right there. Then I could select the right or the left half. I want to select the right half. Tap on that again and hit delete. So I've gotten rid of the rest of that track. Of course, you're probably going to take more time to do this to figure out exactly where the point is that you want to cut the song off. And you can rewind here with that button and hit play to hear it. and then stop and keep adjusting to where you want it to be. If you want to actually extend the song, you can drag the end here and you can see the rest of the song is still there. So you could drag or reduce the amount to get it just right. And then you can exit the song by tapping here, going to My Songs, and you go up a level. Now let's go and name this. I'm going to tap and hold, and if I swipe down I can hit Rename. So I can name this My Ringtone. And now all I need to do is tap and hold it again, and the bottom option there is Share. If I tap that, you can see one of the options is to share it as a ringtone. So I tap that and it will allow me actually to rename the ringtone if I want in there. Also, for future reference, if you want to delete ringtones you've created, tap on your ringtones right here on this screen, and here you can edit and delete them or swipe to delete them. So it's kind of counterintuitive to go back into GarageBand to delete ringtones, but that's how you do it. So all I need to do now is hit Export, and it'll export as a ringtone. And I end up here where I could just hit OK, but I also could hit Use Sound As and immediately assign it as my standard ringtone or text tone or to a specific contact. But I don't have to right now. I could just hit Done, or I could have hit OK before. Now back under Settings, I can go into Sounds and Haptics, and I can change the ringtone. So I can hit Ringtone here, and I can select this new ringtone. You can see it listed right there, My Ringtone. And I could also set it as my text tone or use it any other place that you could use a ringtone on your iPhone. Now there is another place you can get music for a ringtone. Notice if I go to the Loops here, I had Apple Loops and Files, but I also have Music. What I could do is select something from my music library. Now what you're not going to be able to select are songs that are from Apple Music because they're protected. Now what you can select are songs that you ripped from CDs. So if you have those in your collection, they should show up here. But they have to be downloaded. If you're using Apple Music or iTunes Match and you don't actually have the song on your device that just shows up in the list, you have to go into the Music app and actually play it so it downloads and it's on your phone. That's the main reason why you wouldn't see something available here. So here in this list I have mostly gray songs, but I have a few that actually are songs that I ripped from CDs a long time ago, and that's how they're part of my music collection. So I could actually select that, and notice here in this interface I actually drag it right from the list into GarageBand. Another place to get music from is if you search YouTube for royalty-free music. You'll come up with lots of music there that it appears that you could download legally and use as you like. Then you could search for websites that allow you to convert YouTube videos to MP3 downloads. There are a lot of sites like that. They're really sketchy and have tons of ads on them, so I'm not even going to show you one. But you put the YouTube URL into that site and it will produce an MP3. You can download it and then use it just like I used the file here in this tutorial. And of course you can use that for any royalty-free music you find at YouTube, and technically you could use it for anything you'd find at YouTube, although it wouldn't be legal to do it for a song that's under copyright. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.